Alright, so this is like my 2 week update. I've been here for, I think, like 15 days now. And I haven't really vlogged or anything in the past like week. I think maybe Sunday was the last time that I really took any video at all. So I'm gonna just give an update of what has happened this past week and kind of everything in between. So I think it was on, I think maybe on Sunday, I had a high blood pressure during the night, which is very unusual for me, because my blood pressure is usually really good for being pregnant and for twins. And since mom had really bad preeclampsia, they have really been keeping track of my blood pressure and everything like that. So they put me on a 24-hour urine collection test thing. I don't know what it is. But that came back and that was great. They said my levels were awesome and that I'm not really showing any preeclampsia at all, which is absolutely fantastic because I was showing kind of signs of preeclampsia back at, I think it was like 20 weeks, maybe even earlier than that. Then I had my glucose test, and I passed that with flying colors. I mean, we're just super healthy over here. And the babies are looking really, really good. They said their monitoring is awesome. I don't think they had really any really high or really low readings at all. So they said they're looking perfect. And I'm very happy about that. Because I'm still doing the 3 times a day monitoring for half an hour, sometimes even longer than that, depending on how they stay around with the bait or stay around the monitoring if I'm on there that long. But they look great, and so that makes David and I hearts very happy. David, he left on Monday, and it was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. I knew it wasn't going to get perfect, but I thought it was going to get easier. And honestly, I think it was harder this time around, him leaving. And it wasn't necessarily that I didn't know what was happening, and I didn't want him to, that I was going to miss him. I was going to miss him, and I knew that I was going to miss him, but I felt a lot of fear about it, about him leaving. And I really don't know why. And it was only going to be 3 days, I think 3 days, yeah, because he left on Monday night, that I really wasn't going to see him. But for some odd reason, I had so much fear about him being gone. And I don't know if it was fear of something happening and him not being here, or fear of the girls coming, or just in general him not being around for that support. But it was really hard. I don't think it's gonna get any easier. There's that. The next day, my mom came. She was able, she's, like I said, she's the one that like talks to people. I kind of hang back and I let them, if they're gonna hate anybody, I would rather them hate my mom than me. So she was talking to someone, and we've been able to actually go outside and walk around now and actually have permission to walk. Permission to go outside, like officially, because like before it was kind of like a secret, but now we can officially go outside and walk around, and that's been really nice because it gives me something more of like freedom and not feeling that so stuck inside here. However, mom was here on Tuesday, and then on Wednesday, Promise and Andrew tested positive for COVID. So that was kind of devastating because that means that mom's not going to be able to be here for 2 weeks or until their quarantine is up. And with the hospital, how they do it, they have the one support person, which is your main support, which is David, and he can spend the night. And then you have a second support person, and that second support person doesn't change the whole entire time that I've been in the hospital. So the whole entire 6 weeks, my mom was my support person, and it had to be her the whole entire 6 weeks. We couldn't change it out for anything, even if it was at separate times. We weren't able to change them. Emily, again, the nurse that helped us going downstairs, I talked to her and she said that they'd never have experienced that before about the support person being in quarantine. So they went and she talked to all kinds of different people and the nurses, and they actually gave us permission to change my mom being my support person to David's mom being my support person before, in the meantime, while mom is in quarantine. And that was such a relief because I thought that I was probably gonna have to be alone for 2 weeks rather than on whenever David's here. So that was a very big thing. It was so nice to know that. So that's been awesome. But the last few days, I have been extremely exhausted this past week, and that's kind of one of the things why I haven't really videoed or anything. I've just been so tired. I haven't been sleeping very well. And so the past two nights, I've gotten some sleeping pills, and I'm feeling much better. It's been a miracle. Because they have had me on a monitor until at least usually 11, and then I have to get dressed and ready for bed, and then they have me up at 6 a.m. for monitoring again. And it's kind of just hard, especially when you're pregnant and not getting that much sleep. I feel much better, even though I probably don't look like that, and I probably look still tired, but you should have seen me on Wednesday. It was bad. But on to today. Today we have a growth ultrasound for the first time in a month. So we get to see how big they are and if they're growing, which helps me just kind of knowing where they are in their growth and how I can expect if they were to come right now, how healthy they would be. Because we are at 30 weeks almost. We'll be 31 weeks on Sunday, and it's Friday today. So, very close. And I am so excited. His mom is also coming today. And so she's going to be here, and hopefully she can make it for the ultrasound. That's pretty much it for right now. I'm just hanging in there. I don't know if anybody really likes to watch these besides mom and dad and stuff. But I think this will be nice to have for whenever the girls do come, because this is such a weird situation that I think it'd be nice to see, for them to see what we went through and everything to get our beautiful little perfect angels that they are and that we know them.